of flesh and wood, and Jimmy's here in the flesh and wood, and it's a totally acoustic album.
It is.
Nothing electric.
No, except possibly, like you said, the kitchen stove when we're doing catering. No, it's, I wanted to make an album that just, you know, that sort of was stylistically acoustic as opposed to, you know, just rehashing, you know, electric songs. So doing it that way, I wasn't tempted at all to use anything that was electric. You know, we used acoustic bass, you know, real strings, which was great, little quartets, you know, piano accordions, fiddles, you name it, mouth organs. So it worked out really good. I'm really pleased with it. Doing it that way too gave me tons of room to sing, you know, as far as, you know, physical room to actually get out and belt in front.
Well, you say you need, when you're doing it acoustically, you need good songs to hold it up, yeah?
Definitely. So. You know, that's the, I think, the first thing that you notice. Any of those great albums, like, you know, the early Dylan albums that were all, you know, acoustic, say, you know, Harvest, things like that, you know, they're all great songs, and that's just what carries them. That's why people sit around playing those bloody songs repeatedly at parties, you know?
They hold up.
Yeah, because they do hold up, so that was the sort of the first thing we did was actually, you know, look around and make sure we had good songs.
You know? Right, and actually, so you chose a whole good bunch of people to do duets with, because it's a lot of duets on it.
And, Just a couple.
Now, how did you choose the people? Did you just run across them in, you know, in the pub or what?
In the elevator. No, it was almost, you know, like it just fell together. You know, we sat around one night talking about, you know, who I'd like to work with. You know, I couldn't think of doing an acoustic album in this country without using Tommy Emmanuel, because he's probably one of the best acoustic guitar players I've heard. Mm. You can hear him in the background as we speak.
Quite.
Beautiful. Shut up, would you, Tommy?
Shut up.
So Tommy I rang up, and of course we're old mates, and that was, you know, there's no problem. Archie Roach I wanted to work with straight away because I just, you know, love Archie's voice. And
Archie, you wrote a song that you did with Archie.
Yeah, that's right.
You were a bit nervous to let him hear it?
Not to let him hear. I was a bit nervous, mainly because the song's such a heavy lyric as far as, you know, it's an important lyric. It's about reconciliation. And doing a song with Archie about reconciliation, I think Archie's such a great lyricist anyway. Exactly. And has a very subtle way of approaching the black and white relations in this country. So I was very wary about doing it. I wrote the song the night before. I was inspired. And I wrote the tune, and I played it to him the next day and said, look, anything you want to change, go ahead. And he seemed to like it a lot.
He loved it.
So it was great. I was really happy.
And with the Bad Loves, apparently there was a funny thing that came about with a chance sort of they happened to be rehearsing it.
Well, that was really funny because they didn't know I wanted to, you know, record with them. Michael said to me, you know, Gedinski, I was sitting around having a chat with him about the record, and he said, you know, you don't have to sort of restrict yourself to just working with, you know, singers. If you want to, you know, do a duet with a band as such, you know, you can do that. Have you thought about that? And I thought, well, the only band that I, you know, came to mind straight away were, you know, the Bad Loves, just because, you know, it was a new record that was out then. Particularly like Michael's singing. I love the vibe of the band. I love the way they've got this real, they're a real unit. You know, any member of the band, you know, left, they would be, you know, fall apart. They're just a real unit.
Yeah.
And they've got a great feel and a great, unique sound. So I said, yeah, I'll give them a ring, you know. And so I rang them up, and like you said, they'd learnt the song that afternoon to do in their set. So.
Spooky. Yeah. Now, apart from that, you've got Deb Conway on it, you've got Chris Bailey, Don Walker, a whole bunch of things, some great old Chisel songs.
Ross Wilson was a major part of the record. I mean, when Ross came down, I rang him up, said, come down, help me write for some songs. And we ended up pinching half of his solo record. You know, the poor guy's gone back to write again.
Sorry, Ross.
Yeah, but, you know, the songs were just fantastic. And Ross was really instrumental in setting the whole vibe of the record. He was there at the start. His songs were the first three that we did, and then it really did set the tone of the album. It's fantastic.
Cool. Well, this is part of the album right now. You'll find Stone Cold on it. You'll also find the latest single called The Wait with the Bad Loves, which is a very fine song, very fine album. Get it at your local record store. Thanks, Jimmy. Get on with the show, mate.
See you.
Get out there and play.
Go and sing there. Thanks.
I pulled in to Nazareth. I walked feeling about a half past dead. I just need a place where I could lay my head. Hey, mister, can you tell me where a man might find a bed? He just grinned and shook my head, and no was all to say. Take a load off